Let's work on an overhead variance example problem. So for Morgan Company, the standard cost of their product includes 1.5 hours of direct labor at $14 per hour. The predetermined overhead rate is $18 per direct labor hour. In November, Morgan Company incurred 7,000 hours of direct labor at an average rate of $14.25 per hour and $120,000 of manufacturing overhead costs. Morgan Company produced 4,000 units in November. So we are given all of the information that we need to be able to compute the total overhead variance. Here's your formula for the total overhead variance. It's your actual overhead minus your applied overhead. Now, we have our actual overhead. We were told that that was $120,000. So we can plug that into the equation. We weren't told our applied overhead. So we're going to need to solve for that. So your applied overhead, the first step that we're going to do is we're going to take that 1.5 hours of direct labor per unit and multiply it by the number of units that we actually produced in November, that 4,000 amount. That will tell us that based off of that standard, we would have expected to have 6,000 hours of direct labor. Then we take that 6,000 and we multiply it by our predetermined overhead rate. So 6,000 times $18. And we can see that our applied overhead will be $108,000. Now we can come back and put that into our equation for our overhead variance. So our actual overhead of $120,000 minus our applied overhead of $108,000 tells us that our total overhead variance is $12,000. But that's just half of the answer, right? A variance has to either be favorable or unfavorable. So here, we take a look at this and we say that our applied overhead was 108. So we would have expected to need to spend $108,000 on overhead for November. We actually spent $120,000. So we spent more than what we expected. So that makes this overhead variance unfavorable.